With vaults dotted around the landscapes of Fallout and only limited amount of space in each, how do you get the shelter you need when the bombs drop? Well, in steps the Pulowski Preservation Shelter. These shelters may just, at your time of crisis, be what you need to save your life. As you are traversing the urban areas of the Capital Wastelands of Fallout 3, the Commonwealth of Fallout 4, and Appalachia in Fallout 76, you may notice large tubular structures bolted down to pavements on street corners. These one-man coin-operated Fallout shelters is just what a person needs when the bombs inevitably drop. When Pulowski Preservation Services created the shelters, they were advertised as, and I quote, an affordable line of personal protection products to make sure no one gets left behind. By many, they were seen as a viable alternative to Vault-Tec's vaults. I'm sure by now you have noticed the shelters' very thin walls, as well as the fact they don't look too stable. Well, the shelters were made specifically for you to hide from radiation, instead of from the extreme heat or blast waves of the atomic bombs. Anyone that uses the shelters were advised to remain inside until the radiation clears, and to enjoy their stay. The inside of the shelters. The shelters were tube structures with little to no room to actually sit down, but you could stand quite happily. There were pipes connected where you could go to the bathroom, and above your head was a small fan that circulated fresh and clean air for you to breathe. I suppose you could sit down and tuck your knees up under your chin, although that pose is not the most comfortable for long periods. The variants. In Fallout 3, the tubes are dark grey and black in colour. They also look a little battered, and in most cases, you can find occupied being displayed across the top of the shelter. This is also where the fan would sit and allow fresh air to be circulated into the tube's inhabitants. The shelter also has a Geiger counter to confirm the levels of outside radiation. Once you open the shelter, you will inevitably be greeted by a skeleton of the occupier and some loot of some kind. Fallout 4 and Fallout 76's shelters are now a more pleasant sky blue colour, with the occupied display being removed. They are also a little bigger, meaning a little bit more room for their single occupant. Breathing masks and pre-recorded sound clips welcoming the visitor are now also included. The shelter has the same Geiger counter as its Capital Wasteland variant. One more point to note, in Fallout 76, a shelter in Somerville's Lake has been repurposed as a secret entrance to the Riverside Manor basement. Overall, the shelters may seem like a good hideaway from that pesky radiation at a time when you need it most. But seeing how many skeletons there are in them when you open the door, I can only assume they are not good for shelter and only good for holding corpses. The Fallout Wiki puts it best by saying, "The actual effectiveness of the shelters is dubious." Would you put your life in a Pulowski Preservation Shelter? Let me know in the comments. Alright then, my friends, that's we us done for another Fallout Lore video. Thanks ever so much for watching and listening. I've been JD, you've been fantastic as always. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe. Hello and welcome to all the new subscribers. I hope you're enjoying the channel. So until next time, my friends, happy gaming.